Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode on major sins in Islam. Those major sins that every Muslim should be cautious of, every Muslim should know of, every Muslim should be away from. These sins, at the end of the day, the harm of it will only come back to us. Allah will never be harmed and Allah will never be benefited from the good that we do or the bad that we commit. The good that we do, the benefit will come back to us, and the bad that we do will only come back on us. And one of the major sins that Islam forbids, and Islam came to keep people away from it so they could live a peaceful and respectful and happy life, it is gambling. Gambling is when you gamble with your money. This money that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you, and this money that Allah azza wa jalla has sustained you, that you work hard for. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had written on you the amount of money to have in your pocket or in your savings. This money should be brought in the way that pleases Allah Azza wa Jal in the halal and spent in the halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question us in the hereafter and question every single Muslim and every single servant of his about and over their money. Where did they get it from and where did they spend it in? Yes, we'll be questioned over. Where did we get our money from and where did you spend our money in? So if we're going to spend our money in the haram, we're going to spend our money into the gambling, we're going to gamble our money, whether it's in the casino or by playing cards or playing games or any form of gambling, it is haram. Whether it's horse racing or dogs racing or any animals racing or people racing or on a football match, all these types of gamblings are haram. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question us ever, where did you spend our money? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, what's wrong with people from my nation? Misuse their money. What's wrong with people from my nation? They misuse their money without rights. Their destiny is the hellfire wal-iyadu billah in the hereafter. Misusing your money and using your money in the haram, spending it in the haram, or trying to gamble with it, it is only going to take it to the hellfire wal-iyadu billah. So we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with gambling. And what sort of gambling we're talking about? Any form of gambling. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجْسُ مِنْ عَمْلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions that drinking alcohol or wine and gambling, and he mentions other things, are from the actions of the shaytan. فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. Keep away from it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says,
إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُوقِعَ بَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ فِي الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ وَيَصُدَّكُمْ عَن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَعَنِ الصَّلَاةِ فَهَلْ أَنْتُم مُّنْتَهُونَ.
Look to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says about gambling and about drinking wine, that the shaytan, and which is no doubt this is the path of the shaytan wants to bring enmity and hostility between you through drinking and through gambling and keep you away from the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal and from the prayers. Subhanallah, how amazing is that? You find people who drink and people who gamble have always family problems, have social problems. They have problems with their parents. They have problems with their children. They have problems with their wives. They have problems with their husbands. They have problems with their brothers. They have problems with their sisters. They have problems with everyone. Those who gamble and those who drink always have problems with everyone. Why? Because it's exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned. Shaytan wants to bring enmity and hostility between those who, amongst those who gamble and those who drink wine. And you find those that drink and those who gamble, then pray. And really remember Allah Azza wa Jal. Really remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is exactly what the shaytan wants out of gambling. Some people say, but it's my money. I want to do whatever I want to do with it. And I can do with it whatever I wish. Yes, it's your money. But at the end of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for you. And Allah azza wa jalla does not want to bring any harm to you. And Allah azza wa jalla does not want you to bring harm to yourself or to your family. When you drink and when you gamble, not only that you are bringing harm to yourself, but you are bringing harm to your family. You are bringing harm to your children. And not only that, but you keep away from the remembrance of Allah azza wa jalla. Have you met someone who drinks or someone who gambles and prays on time or remembers Allah azza wa jalla? Because those two don't mix. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Salah keeps someone away from the fahsha and keeps you away from the sins. When someone prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prays on time, the salah prevents this person from falling into the haram. prevents this person from falling into such actions and ugly actions such as gambling or drinking. And that's why the shaitan uses these two, uses these forms of gambling and drinking to keep someone away from the salah and to keep someone away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if someone constantly remembers Allah and constantly prays on time, they would not gamble and they would not drink. They would not gamble and they would not drink. And that's very, very rarely to happen. Very, very rarely to happen. That's why gambling is a form of the shaitan, a path of the shaitan. And don't you ever think that you'll win through the shaitan. Don't you ever think you'll become rich through the shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran al-Kareem about the shaitan, يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. Shaitan only promises you poverty. Shaitan only promises you poverty. Any way, any path that you obtain money through the shaitan, you would never become rich. You would never ever become rich. Have you ever met a gambler that became rich? Gamblers only become poor and poor. Gamblers only become sad and sad. Gamblers only destroy their lives and destroy their families and destroy a community. This is the life of a gambler. Have you ever came across a gambler who won and did not put the money back into gambling? That's why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam forbid us from all forms of gambling or anything that leads to gambling, including playing games with dice. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he forbid us from playing games with dice. Why? Because playing games with dice, they'll make you base your life on luck. Anything that's based on luck, it's haram. Any game that's based on luck, it's haram. Any game that's based on fortune is haram. Why? Because the Muslim should not base their life on luck. The Muslim bases his life according to the Quran and Sunnah. The Muslim follows the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Muslim follows the path of Allah and follows the path of his messenger and follows the path of the believers. This is the way of the Muslim, not based on luck, not based on what they think could be good for them or not. The Muslim bases their life according to the Quran and the Sunnah. This is the way of the Muslim. But gamblers base their life on nothing. Gamblers base their life on just luck. And that's why you find a gambler very, very reckless. You find the gambler very reckless on themselves. You find them don't even care about their life, don't even care about their families, don't even care about their wives, don't even care about their children. They are willing to spend millions of dollars spending them on gambling and not even bring a carton of milk to their children. This is the life of gamblers. Is this what pleases Allah Azza wa Jalla? Is this humane? Is this acceptable? How could someone at the end of the day say, but I'm only spending my money? You are destroying your life. And you are destroying your family's life. And you are destroying your parents' life. And you are destroying your kids' life. And you are destroying everyone around you. Do you respect someone who is a gambler? Do you respect someone when you know this person is a gambler? By your natural instinct, you lose respect in those people. Those people who gamble lose respect in society. And those people who gamble will never be put in a position of leadership. These people can't even take care of themselves. How could even they take care of a community or even take care of a nation? Gamblers only destroy themselves, destroy their lives. That's why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbids us from any form of gambling, whether it's little or big, whether it's small or major. We must as Muslims keep away from any form of gambling. Any form of game or any form of sports that's based on luck, it is haram. Haram, haram. And we should keep away from it. And don't you ever, ever be deceived that there is nothing wrong with that. Including lotos. How many people spend their money on a loto? They think that by them putting $10 or $15 is nothing wrong with it. That's haram. And if you win the loto, money that you won is haram. And if you take that money, you're only eating haram. And your ending will be in the hellfire. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that those bodies that grow on the haram, then the hellfire is for them. And have you ever wondered why your dua is not accepted? Well, eating the haram, being involved in the haram, is a form and a way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not accept your dua. Allah azza wa jal ordered us, لَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ. Do not eat, do not deal with your money with batil, with any evil avenue. And one of those evil avenues is no doubt gambling. Gambling of any sort. These days we have so many different types of gambling, so many different types of games, so many different types of companies and casinos and clubs that deliver different types of gambling. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us away from it. All that, whatever it is, whether it's sports or racing or dice or poker machines or casinos, They are all form of gambling. They're all haram. Any of that, including the lotus, including the $2 that you pay for a jackpot that you scratch and you think you're going to get $10,000 out of it, that's also haram. The money that you spend is haram. And the money that you win, if you win, is haram. So all that form of haram. And subhanAllah, what really amazes me, for the gambler, it's so easy for him to spend hundreds of dollars on gambling. It's so easy for him or her to spend thousands of dollars in gambling. But when it comes to donating $10 for the sake of Allah, they become so poor. They become so poor. They are so rich when it comes to donating for the haram, and they are so poor when it comes to donating for the halal. They are so rich when it comes to donating for the shaitan, they are so poor when it comes to donating for their children. They are so rich when it comes to donating for the poker machines and the casinos. And they are so poor when it comes to their families and their own kids. I have experienced families that the father will put hundreds and thousands of dollars and would not even bring milk to the house. Would not even bring nappies to the children and the babies. Is that Islam? Is that acceptable in a way or form? And the gambler will only even continue to become worse. Never stops at one thing. The gambler just continues to become worse. If he can't find money, he'll steal money and commit crime. This is the ending of the gambler. The gambler and those who gamble, not only that they fall into the haram, but they continue falling into the haram, they'll find any avenue, any means just to get money. If it's through drugs, they would not say no. If it's through committing theft, they would not say no. If it's through lying, they would not say no. You find a gambler have all these bad qualities. They become liars. They become thieves. They become dealers in haram. They have all these evil characteristics in them. Exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. That the shaitan wants to destroy you and bring enmity and hostility through gambling and drinking wine and stop you from the remembrance of Allah azza wa jalla and the salah. This is the life of a gambler. The life of a gambler is a life full of corruption. The life of a gambler is a life full of sadness. The life of a gambler is a life full of devastation. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to keep away from gambling. And even not gambling with games that don't even involve money. Because that's a waste of time. Your time is gold. Your time is gold. You should look after your time. Not waste it through playing. Whether playing chess or playing dice or playing any other games. That time should be utilized to the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, take advantage of 5 before 5. And then he said, فَرَاغِكَ قَبْلَ شُغْلِكَ. Your time, take care of it before you get occupied. Don't waste your time through games. And don't waste your time through playing games and playing dice. And waste your time through gambling. Put your time to your benefit. A Muslim always benefits. And a Muslim, wherever he goes, he benefits and people benefit from him. A Muslim utilizes his time for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not sit down. You find people sit down, play cards for hours and hours and hours. And when it comes to praying 5 minutes, I find it too hard. When it comes to attending the jama'ah prayer, they find it too hard. When it comes to giving their parents or their mum or father or helping their wife or shopping, they find it too hard. But it is so easy to sit for hours a night playing cards. Is that Islam? Is that the character of a good person? My brothers and sisters, keep away from gambling. Any form of gambling, any form of games that involve luck, or any form of game that involve cards or dice, it is only destroying you in this world and destroys you in the hereafter. Misery in this world and hellfire in the hereafter. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to protect us and protect our families and children from such an evil action. Allahumma ja'alna min alladhina yastami'una al-qawl fayattabi'una ahsana. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.